Tradition is, to me, it's a term that I think really encompasses the fans, the players, and kind of brings them together.
You think back to Purdue and think about the Sports Illustrated covers from the 60s and the Greasies and the Leroy Keys, Jack Mollenkopf. And so in that sense, it's been sort of a two-piece tradition, if you will, in the 60s and then the 90s with Coach Tiller.
You see all the great players that have been around. I mean, it's just something that to be a part of it is amazing.
We've had some great teams. We've had some experiences with the Rose Bowl. If you look at the last 12 years, we've been to postseason play 10 of the last 12 years, which puts us somewhere in the top 10 or 15% of postseason play in Division I football. So I think we have an outstanding tradition based on pride and work ethic.
When I think about our Purdue football teams and the better teams we've had over the years, they have been teams that have been spirited, they've been competitive, they've had a little bounce in their step. And to me, you can feel it.
Tradition to me means doing it year in and year out and having a respect for history, respect for the past, and looking forward to building and adding to that when you play and then becoming part of that tradition.
Purdue has a lot of mystique about it, and they had good football teams and they played in the Big Ten, which was, in the years that I played, was probably the best conference in the country.
And, I think Purdue is really taking a step forward with just, you know, the level of competition that we're able to provide in the Big Ten. And, you know, we've got a lot of quality players, a lot of quality coaches, and you know, it's a really, really solid university, you know. So Purdue is really starting to step out into the limelight.
Yeah, we went with the boiler up theme a long time ago. I think that was Arnett that came up with that. And I think they kind of got everybody in the right groove, you know. Everybody was kind of quiet before that. Now they're boiling up all over the place.
Purdue football is a family. It's not an era. It's not a particular coach. It's not a particular player. It's Purdue football. When you put on that helmet, you are a Boilermaker for life. And that family that we have goes beyond football. It goes into life. And to bring back that tradition, to have the athletes coming back and mentoring to the younger guys and getting those guys set up for the future, that's what I'd like to see come back.
Being a Boilermaker to me is the foundation of who I am as a person. I think when it comes to what my parents taught me on an everyday basis, beliefs, discipline, tradition, as I explained earlier, values in life, all those things culminated to the opportunity to come here to Purdue to be a student athlete.
I think the fans are huge. You know, when Ross-Ade Stadium gets loud, the students standing and cheering the whole time, I think it's a big factor.
I think the fans is a very important role. As a player, you know, when you come into that stadium, you know, whether you're on the road or playing a home game, you feed off the energy from the fans.
You gotta love Boilermaker fans, man. Just being the atmosphere, coming out in Ross-Ade Stadium on a Saturday afternoon and being in this type of atmosphere. I came to a couple games when I was younger and I was just like, this is definitely what I want to do in my life.
If you're a Purdue fan, all you gotta do is make some noise. I can tell you one thing, as an offensive lineman, if you can't hear the snap count, life is not good.
If you're a diehard and if you're really true to the heart, a Boilermaker fan, a Boilermaker supporter, through the good and the bad, you'll be there to show those kids, those student athletes, that what you're doing is positive. Continue to do that, and we'll be here to back you and cheer you on.
Kind of like being a parent, you always want the better life for your offspring. Well, I think it's the same when you're a former player at a given university. You know, the guys who are playing nowadays, we want to see them break our records. We want to see them go to as many bowl games or more than we went to. We want to see them do everything we did and more to keep building that program. So I think in that sense, it's a continual building process.
You know, we look back at the coaches who have come across the field to coach Purdue. We look at the players who have played here at Purdue. And now we're trying to bridge that gap and reconnect players from the different eras, so that there's a continuity, because we all know that nothing lasts forever. And but as we continue to let the younger players understand what we went through, we understand their efforts, we understand things that happen on the field, maybe a little different than the fan in the stand. So it's that tradition is embracing one another, understanding that you are part of something great.
If we can continue to gather the support of the ex student athletes to come back and support, regardless of what the record or the score is, to support what Morgan Burke is doing in the athletic department, Coach Hope as the head coach, then that will show the kids that are out there now that this is something special. And you can't build a house and put the electrical wiring until you have a foundation.
I think Coach Hope brings a level of, he brings a certain attitude to Purdue football. You know, he's a real fiery coach, real fiery competitor. And I had a good chance of being, I had the opportunity to be recruited by him out of Texas. And, I saw that in his personality, in the first times that I met him, I was able to understand, what kind of guy he was. And I can't see anything but good things, lined up for Purdue with Coach Hope at the helm in the future.
Tenacity. He was the coach that was in the middle of, if you're running a drill, he's in there showing you physically, showing you how to do it, or he'll throw you out of the way and he'll do it himself just to show you how to do it. He's not just telling you how to, for me to run a route or how to block somebody. He's actually in there, throwing you around.
Really being physical, having a physical football team is something that he prides himself on. He's going to have guys that go out there and they're going to know what to do, they're going to know how to do it, and they're going to play the game hard. And if you can do those three things, you'll win games.
I think a lot of it had to do with the great experience that we had the last go-around when we came in 97 with Coach Tiller and had success immediately, and the fans got excited and rallied behind the staff and the football team. It was just one of the great experiences and great stories in college football, and an opportunity to come back to Purdue and do that again was a no-brainer.
This is what it is. SV, Urban Organic, Mike Mechanic, Superhuman MC Powers help me fly around the planet. Touch the microphone device, whole countries get frantic. Saving damsels in distress so young girls don't panic. Put MCs under pressure till they crack like ceramic. I was thought they could float, but sank like the Titanic. Rhymes rip through your skull like icebergs through the hull. Survive the impact and Arctic cold freezes your soul. Create a new style, then break the mold. Positions are controlled and liable to explode like lamb.